If you remember in the previous program, I showed you how you can write your name onto a file. Now using fscanf, which is very similar to scanf, I'll show you how you can read your name back from the file you had written. So I have defined an array of characters name called as size 50. I have defined a pointer to a file kind of a structure which is defined in stdio.h as *fptr. Then I am using the same name to open the file. I am saying fptr is equal to fopen myname.txt, because in the previous program I had shown you opening this file in write mode, I wrote my name. Now I am want to read my name. Since read mode is R, I am putting R in double quotes. So if this file was not created, fptr would become null. So if fptr is null, then it indicates that I had some problem opening the file. Otherwise, I am perfectly fine. Then what I am going to do here is, I am simply going to say fscanf %s name. Name is the data which is stored on your hard disk is of the type %s, and that means it's a string. So Arjun was the name we entered. Arjun is going to be stored in name of 50. fptr stands for the input stream. What is your input stream? Input stream happens to be your file on the disk whose name is myname.txt. So fptr represents your input stream, which is myname.txt. Your input stream can also be your keyboard. So in place of fptr, if you're reading from the keyboard, you would write stdin. Now to see if it is doing it correctly, I'm just going to use a printf to print my name. And then I'm going to say fclose file pointer and close. So in order to understand how the fscanf works, you need to look at the prototype. Develop a habit of looking at the prototype of functions to give you clarity about how a function works. So fscanf, the first parameter happens to be the source of input or the stream. The source of input in this case happens to be a file. Next, this conversion specifier, %s, that's a constant string, okay, because it's in double quote. And then instead of reading just one %f, instead of reading one name, I can have multiple %s and I can read name 1, name 2, name 3. So you can have multiple parameters here, you can have multiple arguments here. So that's why I'm saying 0 or more arguments. Now, if fscanf is successful in reading here, then what it will return is, it will return the number of items matched and assigned to input items correctly. Let me explain what I mean. Suppose I have name 1 and name 2. I have %s and %s. So in this case, one %s matches with name 1. The second %s matches with name 2. So what it's trying to say is, there are two control strings, both match with name 1 and name 2, and I am able to read data into both name 1 and name 2. Since I am able to read two items, fscanf will return an integer value of 2. But suppose I am not able to read any data, that means the file doesn't have any data, it is end of the file, then you will receive the end of the file value as the return value. It could be -1 or whatever it is, depending on the operating system. So if it's not able to read, you will get the end of the file message, or for some reason, if there is error, it will also give you the error code for why it is not able to read. So this is the prototype of fscanf. This is the code for fscanf. Again, just to remind you, please go and watch the demo which follows this particular program. Most important, with files more than any other thing, maybe after pointers, you must start typing the program and start running the code. You will begin to understand as you begin to use it more and more. So don't wait till you understand everything. That is never going to happen. When you understand a little bit, start typing, run the code, play around a bit, and then you will increase your understanding, and finally you will find it quite simple.